Well, it is the first time we've seen the Mike Vigor fan club flag back up there. It's on the right-hand side of your screen. You'll see it when the action gets underway. Let's take you straight into tonight's team news, starting with the Bristol Flyers. And, of course, Jalen McLeod remains out with that foot injury he picked up against London Lions. That's going to be a huge blow for Bristol here tonight.
It is. It is a big kind of loss for Bristol, because he just adds that bit of flair, that bit of kind of unpredictability as well. You know, he goes to the basket strong, and if we're not shooting well as a team, you know, he can get to the basket for a small guy. He's quick, and just not having that element of offense there as well is a blow. So, you know, the last kind of games I watched of Flyers, if their shooting's not quite right, if they're not shooting well, they struggle. And he offers, Jalen offers that kind of, like I said, ability to get to the basket and to cause defenses problems, which opens up the wings for easier shots.
Well, it is Lewis Champion that gets the nod at point guard for Coach K. Along with no changes to the starting lineup that lost to Leicester Riders by a single point last weekend, as we get underway here at the College Arena. And it's Champion top to Gray. Now here's Fred Thomas, who pulls up from a mid-range two front iron, and the rebound's gathered in by Mike Tuck. Here's Anthony Collins. Of course, didn't play that game last week against, last time Flyers met Sheffield Sharks back in September. And now there's Marsden going to work inside. Comes up short on that one. And a rebound gathered in by Daniel Adozie.
Yeah, Collins certainly looks like the facilitator for the Sheffield team, averaging 8.5 assists a game. So that'll be certainly a help since the last time Sheffield came to town.
Well, it was a beautiful pass there from Fousen to find Thomas, but just couldn't quite finish inside. And it's going to be Dirk Williams, I believe, who picks up his first personal foul. As Gray gets us back underway from the sideline, it's Champion. Thomas is looking for it, swings it to Gray, pulls up for three from the wing, and the ball rattles around the rim, but no good. And now here's Collins. It's a beautiful pass to Marsden, and Justin Gray just throws it away.
That was a big bat. Huge block by Gray. We've seen that a few times here at the Wise Arena as well.
Now, Justin Gray, he's become known for it at the moment with the Flyers and tense defensive players. Reason why Coach K brought him in. And a 5-second violation there on Sheffield Sharks.
Yeah, you don't see too many of those being called in the BBL.
It's going to be Flyers ball here from the baseline. Thousand gets us back underway. Here's Lewis Champion. Now top to Tevin Thousand. Hands off with Fred Thomas. It's Thousand inside, up against Marsden, pulls up for two. Back iron, a very slow start for both teams here. Both sides yet to get points on the board.
Yeah, kind of all the offenses so far from the Flyers have been kind of threes and jump shots, you know, no one really putting pressure under the basket, and that's kind of what we touched on. If they're not shooting well, they do struggle to score.
Well, right on cue there, Dirk Williams knocks down a three-pointer from the baseline, and that one gets Sheffield Sharks off to an early three-point lead. Is Gray. Full team comes, point into Thousand. Thousand looking for options inside, and too much on the mid-range two, but able to gather in his own miss. It's Thomas on the wing. Shot clock down to six. Thomas, ball comes off the foot of Dirk Williams. It's going to be reset here. Of course, Bristol last weekend coming up short against Leicester Riders by that single point. I mean, that game went all the way, and Flyers came back from double-digit deficit and went down to that final possession. That was an incredible game last weekend.
Yeah, they certainly toughed it out. I mean, they had a really difficult first half, but they managed to regroup, and Fred Thomas in the third quarter made a real difference that Flyers win. He was shooting. He was on fire, really pulled his team back into it.
Well, there's Tevin Thousand, who gets his tally off the night, and Flyers onto the board, now trail by one. Mike Tuck goes to work down low, up against Edozie, and too much on that one. And that's going to be a great matchup tonight. Tough against Edozie, two former Commonwealth teammates.
That's right, two England players there. Know each other probably a little bit better before and test each other's skills.
Champions long range three off the mark. And now here comes Sheffield the other way. It's Alexander. Nice pass inside to Marsden, who can't finish. And this time gets fouled inside, so it's going to take his first trip to the free throw line tonight.
Packed arena again once more on a Friday night here in Bristol.
Yeah, I mean, the game's been sold out here at SGS College Arena for over a month. Of course, the opponent originally, they bought tickets for the London City Royals, and the fixtures recently got swapped over. The opponents got swapped over. And once again, great to see the Flyers fans here in their numbers.
It's been a few weeks, well, so first game back after the Christmas break and the new year, so Bristol hungry for some basketball action.
It's Fowles on top of the three-point line, now the champion. Kicks it back top to Fowles. It's Fred Thomas, guarded by Williams, and champion again fires up for three. Off the mark, offensive board gathered in by Gray. Beautiful pass for a cutting Lewis champion, just couldn't quite connect on that one. And here come Sheffield Sharks. Stolen away there by Edozie, and Gray around the back dribble. Beautiful move. Justin Gray can't finish, but there's Fowles on the follow.
Nice effort played by Fowles there, just following up. Unusual for Gray to miss a layup like that, but Fowles was the man in the spot just to tap it in for the two. Need some easy scores like that.
Unable to connect there with the pass from Mike Tuck just turned it over. I think it's going to be Flyers basketball. And Rob Marsden takes an early breather. In comes Cedel Hansen-Young. One-point ball game here. Midway through this first quarter. Very low-scoring game indeed. And here's Daniel Edozie looking inside. And it's a great pass inside to find Justin Gray. And able to draw that contact.
Yeah, it was a call. You know, Coach Kapoulos there was calling a play for Justin on the sideline. They saw that he had a bit of a mismatch inside. Gave him the ball at the top of the elbow there, and gave it back to him inside. Got the post up move. Got fouled. Finds himself going to the basket for two free throws.
It will be interesting to see how Thomas and Gray match up against Dirk Williams and Chris Alexander. Of course, you know, last weekend they combined for 64 points in that win over Worcester Wolves, and that's going to be a tough ask for both of those guys to, you know, big matchup indeed. Certainly one to watch here tonight.
Yeah, there's certainly firepower with Alexander and Williams. Both are averaging around 20 points a game.
Well, great, unable to convert on the free throw, but does convert inside, and Bristol Flyers take their first lead of the game. Hanson Young. And Tuck. Here's Collins now looking for Williams. He's open for three. And Williams' ball goes in and out. And the rebound's gathered in by Fowles. Stolen away there by Collins. Able to dribble his way out of traffic. And now finds Williams the other way in transition. And lays it up and in.
Quick hands by Collins there, well anticipated, getting the steal, and Sheffield running the break nicely for the two.
All tied up at 7 points apiece here, and Thomas up against Collins for three. And way off the mark there from Fred Thomas. And Mike Vigor steps onto the court for the first time since rejoining the club. And it's only a great sight to see there for Bristol Flyers fans.
Yeah, talking about returns to the club, see Leslie Smith no longer on the Sheffield roster.
Well, I'm sure when most of the Flyers fans were looking at this fixture, they were looking forward to anticipated reunion there, but released last week by Sheffield. And now here come Flyers the other way in transition. Champion for three. 0 for 3 from beyond the arc tonight for Lewis Champion. And a step up into that starting point guard role in the absence of McLeod. Strong game against Leicester Riders last weekend. And had to play extended minutes against London. There is a timeout called on the floor, 7 points apiece. Very low scoring game so far, Gareth.
Yeah, I mean, you can sort of tell that both teams are in that kind of little slump at the minute as well. There's not that confidence, that free flowing, that just kind of shoot on sight sort of attitude. It is very kind of nervous out there. You can sort of tell both teams kind of having to deal with that sort of lack of confidence, I suppose. But, you know, things in basketball can turn around really quickly. We saw Fred Thomas in the third quarter last week really turn it around and shot the lights out in that quarter, so it can do that. But collectively as a unit, you know, both teams not quite kind of feeling the rhythm just yet.
Well, 7 points apiece is the score. We've just gone past the midway point of this first quarter. We'll be back with you in a couple of moments' time.
Inbound the ball.
Back underway here at the Wise campus, and Vigor pulls up for three, no good. Rebound gathered in by Dirk Williams. And now here comes Hanson Young for the Sharks, guarded by Champion. Top to Collins. Ball screen comes, and now back top to Collins again. Shot clock down to 6 seconds. Collins up against Vigor. Kicks it out, Marsden, mid-range two, nothing but net, knocks it down on the buzzer.
Yeah, there's our man Collins with an assist, certainly building a reputation for those, and you love to play with a player that can find you the ball in those sort of open spots.
It's Lewis Champion, ball screen comes from Vigor. Champion now top to Gray. Shot clock down to 6 seconds here, and Fred Thomas finds himself open for three, fakes it, drives inside, and Gray's got to pull up deep three. Back iron, no good, and another offensive rebound for the Flyers. Thought they did well against Leicester Riders last weekend. He's crashed those boards, and here's Thomas for mid-range two, no good. Gray unable to follow. Now here's Collins for the Sharks. Nice pass for Marsden, and he's unable to finish. And the rebound secured by Vigor.
Good ball movement though by Sheffield, to create that score underneath, or that opportunity underneath, and. Yeah, Marsden normally so reliable under the basket there, you know, he's one of my favourite players in the BBL, fundamentally in the post, and he's a really, really good player, but just missing that kind of bunny under the basket there.
Of course, he had that previous spell with Leeds Force as well in the league, so very experienced player, knows what to expect from BBL basketball, and as you say, very fundamentally sound. It's the little things that Marsden does that... why Sheffield Sharks fans love him.
Yeah, I mean, he's yeah, I guess he is an undersized centre, but you know, his fundamentals and footwork, really something to talk about.
Del Pesh is into the game for the first time tonight, and here he is up against Tuck. Now top to Nichols. Ball screen comes from Del Pesh, who rolls to the basket. I think they're looking for him inside. Now Gray up against Williams, mid-range two, and nothing but net from Justin Gray. A tough shot there, hand in the face.
It is a tough shot. Nothing much more you can do that as a Sheffield player, but you know that it's a tough shot for 2 points. You know, you want to be getting kind of easier scores than that, really, if you want to try and break away from the Sheffield team.
Is Dirk Williams now guarded by Gray. Top to Tuck. Now Hanson Young kicks it out for the baseline, mid-range two, and the ball rattles around the rim. No good from Martin.
Yeah, Sheffield not having much luck either under the basket, creating good opportunities though.
Here's Gray, fires up another three, and this time off the mark. Another rebound for Williams. Alexander fakes it, drives inside and can't finish. End-to-end stuff, but
not much result.
Not able to finish.
No.
Mayan Dombey fires one up, back iron.
Yeah, there's lids on both baskets at the minute.
You just feel like all of a sudden this game is about to explode, but which team's going to pull away first? Here's Alexander. Now Williams up against Gray once again. Step back for three, back of the rim, another rebound from Vigor.
tough shot from Williams there as well. I'm sure both teams will be looking to get some easier scores.
The Flyers shooting just 23% from the field in this first quarter. And both teams yet to get in double digits as we approach the final minute of action in these first 10 minutes. Nichols, out wide to Mayan Dombe. Now here's Delpech. Has to put it up here with the shot clock winding down and nothing on that one. And the rebound's gathered in by the Sharks once again. Alexander puts on the engines, can't finish the layup, and another rebound falls to Delpech. And I mean, end-to-end stuff here for both teams.
It's going to be a tough edit on this highlight reel maybe on Monday.
Here's Justin Gray. Ball screen comes from Delpech. Well, certainly one for the defensive-minded fan. Both teams on 9 points so far. 23 seconds to go here. And 8 seconds between shot and game clock. Here's Alexander. Guarded by Mayan Dombe to the rim. And fouled
still
on his way
drop.
To the basket. Yeah. But unable to get that to shot to go. It's going to be Chris Alexander to shoot a pair of free throws.
10 seconds left in this first quarter. 9 points apiece. Both teams struggling to find any sort of rhythm at the minute offensively.
Well, there are two other games going on in the BBL Championship tonight. And Worcester Wolves are in action at home against London Lions. And it's London who have an early 10-point lead in that one towards the end of the first quarter. And of course, Newcastle Eagles, they're in action against Manchester Giants up at the new Eagles Community Arena. And it's a 2-point game as they approach the end of the first.
Yeah, and just to say about Worcester as well, with Ty Shaw, you know, we hope, wish him a speedy recovery as well. You know, that's, you know, it wasn't good news coming out of Worcester. And yeah, we wish him all the best from the Bristol Flyers.
Now, Dirk Williams takes a seat here for Sheffield. And final 10 seconds of action here is Nichols. Guarded by Hanson Young. Final 5 seconds here. And to Vigor, pulls up mid-range two. Nothing but net, Mike Vigor. And that's going to do it for the end of the first quarter. So as you were here, 11 points apiece. Now both teams, defensive end, you're looking good. You've held a team to 11 points, but just can't quite put the ball in the basket here, Gary.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if it's the defense or just, you know, not finishing offensively. I mean, we saw Sheffield probably miss a couple of layups. We've seen Bristol miss a few layups as well. So I'm not sure if a little bit to do with the defense. But, yeah, just either team just not been able to finish some easier looks. And then combined with some really difficult kind of pull-up jump shots, we've seen some kind of good dribbles between the legs and then pulling up and just sort of not making those shots, which sort of happens when confidence is not high. So, yeah, a bit of a struggle this first quarter for both teams.
What a matchup to watch tonight has lived up to expectation because Dirk Williams and Justin Gray are leading the way for both of their teams. They're 5 points apiece to lead each side, and it's Tevin Fowler not far behind on 4, and also 4 points for Rob Marsden. But we've reached the end of the first quarter here at the SGS College Arena. It's Bristol Flyers 11, Sheffield Sharks 11.
Welcome back to the SGS Wise Arena. Just joining us in the second quarter. Sheffield inbound in the ball. 11 points apiece.
Chris Alexander to get us back on the way. Here he is, guarded by Nichols. And a very low scoring game for both teams so far. Let's hope to see if they can get something going here in in the second quarter.
Yeah, I think someone who's really stepped up actually is Jordan Nichols actually in the past few games as well. You know, he's really kind of stepped up and he's got extended minutes with injuries to the Bristol to Jalen. So yeah, really impressed with him, the way he stepped up and managed the point guard position.
Well, I think it comes up short on one end, and now here's Alexander for the Sharks and gets it to go, and a foul. It's going to be Chris Alexander, chance to go to the line for a three-point play. Of course, back of his second year with the Sheffield Sharks, Chris Alexander, and they're able to retain quite a lot of their players from last year. Of course, Dirk Williams, again, another player, huge impact for this team last season. And of course, Mike Tuck, who's pledged to finish his career here with the club as well, so able to keep that consistency in this Sheffield Sharks squad.
Yeah, I don't know how many seasons it's been Mike Tuck now, but it must be getting close to double figures, I would have thought, for sure. But yeah, real stalwart for the Sheffield Sharks.
Well, last touch by the Flyers, it's going to be Sheffield the other way, and they're on top by three. Collins guarded by Mayan Dombe. Collins blows past Mayan Dombe, and Marsden again, mid-range two. He likes that baseline jumper and makes no mistakes that time.
Yeah, Collins again creating, sucking defenders in and just creating that bit of space for that baseline mid-range shot. Wide open there, knocks it down.
Here's Nichols to the rim, puts it up though. Good offensive board tap by Mike Vigor, and there's Del Pesch to clean up the mess.
Sheffield will be a bit disappointed with their rebound in there.
Stolen away there by Del Pesch, and now here comes Nichols the other way. Kicks it out to Chris Taylor into the game, and now back inside to Marcus Del Pesch. Going to work down low. Beautiful move from Marcus Del Pesch, and a couple of back-to-back scores there. And of course, Del Pesch had that fantastic game against Sheffield when these teams met back in September.
Yeah, his minutes have been probably not as many minutes as he did at the start of the season, but he does offer that kind of post inside play, which I think sometimes Bristol do miss, that inside presence and just being able to try and score in a different way. Like we just saw there, nice post up move, and Panos nearly with the block.
He's going to send Sheffield to the foul line, and Rob Marsden again shoot a pair of free throws for Sheffield.
Panos sits down. Thomas comes back into the game.
He just joined us. It is a one-point game here at the College Arena. Well, a two-point game now, in fact. It's been a very low-scoring first quarter. It was 11 points apiece after the first 10 minutes. And both teams starting to get things going a little bit more now. But first home game of the calendar year for the Flyers. Here's Mike Vigor, top to Thomas. Now Nichols' ball screen comes from Del Pesch. Skips it inside, and again Del Pesch able to get it going inside for the Flyers.
Yeah, nice offense there. I'm just saying about Jordan Nichols, where he's got very good vision, actually, you know, for a guy that's stepping up into the BBL. You know, lovely pass, well executed pick and roll.
Bakovic into the game, now top to Alexander, shot clock down to 10, up against Nichols. Alexander step back for three, front of the rim, another rebound falls to Del Pesch. Here's Nichols, turnover there from Jordan Nichols, just lost handle there of the basketball, and it's going to be Chris Alexander as he gets back underway from the side.
Coach Capula screaming for a bit of full court pressure.
1 point game on our hands here. It's Dirk Williams. Now top to Marsden. Here's Collins. Now Williams to Alexander, guarded by Fred Thomas. Shot clock down to 6 seconds. Still with Alexander, now being guarded by Del Pesch, and puts it up. Just lost it there and has to put it up as the shot clock expires. And the rebound's gathered in by Thomas. Fred Thomas all the way to the rim, no good. And now Sharks have numbers here in transition. It's Collins, beautiful pass to Williams, who lays it in for two.
Yeah, nice break by Sheffield, coming from good defensive play there. 3-on-1, no mistaking that layup there, no problem.
Now it's a 4-point game. Sharks on top. Here's Thomas. Delpech hands off with Nichols, who pulls up from the elbow. Chris Taylor able to gather in the offensive board and draws the foul, sending him to the foul line.
Yeah, Bristol doing quite a good job on the offensive boards. I'm sure Sheffield will want to try and address that issue, because they are getting a few second opportunities.
That's their ninth offensive rebound in this game so far. They've got 19 rebounds in total, so actually grabbing more offensive rebounds than defensive rebounds right now.
Yeah, you can sort of tell that. And said Sheffield will definitely want to try and talk about that and box out a little bit better and grab the balls, because when they're in transition, you know, there's probably no better team getting out and running there.
Of course, they released, you mentioned it earlier, they released Leslie Smith last week, and of course, Flyers fans will know what Leslie Smith can do on the boards, and you know, without that, that third big man inside, you really see that that front court sort of thinning out quite a bit.
Yeah, there's no kind of real kind of big, you know, we've seen in the league some real kind of dominant big men in the league, you know, Manchester with Clayton and Gettys now back at Cheshire, but both these teams probably a little bit more undersized, if you like, in general, but need to make sure you're boxing out your player.
Here's Martin, guarded by Taylor, now top to Williams. Tuck's looking for it inside. Here is Mike Tuck from the baseline, knocks it down as the shot clock expires. And Sharks beginning to build this lead here. Well, it's a beautiful pass from Taylor to feed a Dozy.
Sheffield scoring quite well on this kind of mid-range baseline plays that they're running. They seem to be finding good looks from there. Dozy just reaching in, picking up a foul on Tuck.
His first personal foul on Daniel Adozi. And of course now with that extra big in the rotation in Mike Vigor, you can afford for your big men to pick up a few of those fouls, because of course you've got Adozi and Vigor along with Delpech, and you've also got Fowlson who can play sort of that four, potentially even five position. So
yeah, definitely. Yeah, it does enable you to be a little bit more aggressive and maybe take a couple of early chances, if you like. I mean, obviously, if the game's getting tight and you're on foul trouble, then you don't want to. Again, no layup opportunity there. Missed the layup.
An easy layup inside, missed by Williams, and that kind of sums up this game here so far tonight. It's Fowlson. Now top to Taylor. Up against Martin. Taylor, step back for three, and nothing but net for Chris Taylor. It's good to see some of the bench players for Bristol really stepping up now in the absence of Jaden McLeod.
Yeah, they have to, you know. Someone needs to step up and get Bristol out of this rut here. So all the players are responsible. Big shot there for three.
And just like that, all of a sudden the lid wasn't coming off in the first quarter, and now a pair of back-to-back threes. So that can spark a bit of momentum here for both teams. Fowlson now top to Champion. For Thomas, skips it to Taylor. Beautiful pass for Fowlson, who lays it in. And now Bristol Flyers are back on top. And a timeout has been called here. Has it been a timeout been called? Or?
Yeah, I think the Lions called a timeout.
Yep. Yeah. Timeout has been called here. Bristol Flyers are back out in front by one. And with 4 minutes to go in this first half, we'll see you in a couple of moments' time. Come back to the SGS College Arena, where the hometown Flyers lead the Sheffield Sharks 26 points to 25 in a game that's been a bit choppy here, to be honest with you. And there's anyone's for the taking right now, as both teams shooting around 30% from the field.
Yeah, there's a bit of momentum gaining for both both teams there. So the timeout, hopefully things will continue from where we left off there and not kind of replicate what we saw in the first quarter.
Here's Dirk Williams. Bit of full court pressure now being played from the Flyers.
Yeah, 1-2-2 press from the Flyers. Just show Sheffield something a little bit different.
Collins to Williams. Now step back. Here is Collins once again, guarded by Champion. Now Hanson Young, as the shot clock reaches six, drives inside, no good. And rebound for Daniel Adozie. Taylor for three. It's feeling it, Chris Taylor. Back-to-back threes for the Flyers. Puts them on top, 29 points to 25.
Yeah, Chris Taylor feeling a little bit. Made one a couple of minutes ago and pull up three. Nice shot.
Hanson Young out wide to Collins. Drives inside. Now Marsden here. Tuck works his way down low. Puts it up, no good. Unable to draw that contact from Mike Tuck. It's going to send him to the foul line.
Yeah, both teams showing good energy off the timeout as well. Tuck, another one with really sound fundamentals as well.
Wow. He's averaging 10 points a game this season for Sheffield, and again, he's one of those players you can certainly rely on in your side. And he's makes the first free throw. Chance here to bring Sharks back to within two. Comes up short on the second. Now here's Fred Thomas, throws it up to Chris Taylor, who throws it down, alley-oop slam.
Chris Taylor. I don't think I've ever seen him dunk in a game, actually. That might be a first.
Might be a first time we've seen him dunk it.
He pointed up to the sky, though. He saw the opportunity. He wanted it tossed up there and got obliged and finished it.
Here's Williams up against Adozie. Step back from mid-range, front eye, and another rebound gathered in by Fauzan. And now, bit of momentum. You feel it's starting to shift in Flyers' favour. It's Fauzan up against Tuck. Gathers in his own miss. He's still with Tevin Fauzan. Kicks it out to Adozie. Shot clock at 10. Taylor. What about shooting the three there? And Champion will shoot the three. And Lewis Champion drains a triple. And now Flyers with that 8-point lead, their biggest of the game so far.
Yeah, both teams showing a good energy now. Flyers team up for the challenge. This full court press is slowing Sheffield down a little bit.
Here's Collins. Now Hanson Young for three. Way short on that one. Offensive board by Tuck. And throws it straight to Fauzan.
And there's numbers if... Oh.
The foul's been called on Hanson Young, and Coach Lyons on his feet, not happy with that call.
I'm not sure if he's unhappy with the call or the player. Yeah, I think he's unhappy with the player. Yeah.
Shot that three-point jump shot and then fouled the other way in transition, and now finds himself sat on the end of the bench.
Yeah, right at the end of the bench there. Coach not happy.
Chance here for Bristol to extend their lead to double digits here, or 11 if they can knock down a three. Here's Champion. Champion turns the corner, beautiful move, and Fauzan open for three. Back eye, an offensive rebound falls to Daniel Adozie, crashing the boards the Flyers are, and now here's Thomas for three. And the three's no good. Collins for the Sharks, now out wide to Alexander, guarded by Taylor. Collins once again, shot clock down to seven. And a bit of Collins. Miscommunication there between Collins and Alexander as he throws it out of bounds.
Yeah, it's interesting watching Collins play. You know, he's not really looking at the basket, he's always looking for his teammates there as well, and maybe that's just taken away a little bit from his game there, kind of stepping off a little bit, looking to make that pass.
Here's Lewis Champion, now top to Thomas. Nice pass for Taylor, skips it to Fauzan. Thought about the three, drives inside, unable to convert. last touch by the Flyers, said the referee. What a beautiful pass in transition, and Flyers just caught napping there on defence.
Yeah, just switched off, and that's how quickly you can do damage on a any sort of press, really, that you are susceptible to that pass long. Flyers just switched off, and no one picked up the open man for the layup.
It's a dozy. Now, Taylor, ball screen from Fousen. Fousen inside, skips it to Thomas. Beautiful pass for Fred Thomas, who throws it down.
Wow, he just kept going up then.
Well, he took the elevator all the way to the top floor.
When he took off, there was no way he's going to finish that.
What a play from Fred Thomas to end this second quarter. Alexander ends up on the deck. It's going to be a foul. And Flyers are in a penalty here, so he's going to send Alexander to the free throw line. Timeout is called on the floor by Coach K. It's Bristol Flyers 36, the Sheffield Sharks 28. Back to the SGS College Arena, where before the break, Fred Thomas just got the fans into this game here at the Wise campus with a huge two-handed throwdown. And then Flyers found the other end, and they're in the penalty here, so it is sending Alexander to the free throw line.
Alexander actually leading the league in free throw percentages.
Certainly not the player you want to send to the line come any late game situations.
92% from the free throw line, 101 from 110 attempts, so it could be a rare moment. Nope.
Are you looking for a commentator's curse there?
No, not at all, Joel. I'd hate for that to happen.
Alexander, as I mentioned, second year with the club, he's been a huge presence for this Sheffield Sharks team in their backcourt.
No mistake in that. That's why he's shooting 92%.
Here's Lewis Champion now. Final 17 seconds, and the shot clock is turned off. Here's Champion. Ball screen comes from Fousen. Final 6 seconds. Thomas for three. Off the mark. Offensive rebound by Daniel Adozie. And that's been the story of this first half of Bristol Flyers. They've dominated the offensive glass, and they find themselves up by 8 points at halftime.
Yeah, it's been their Achilles heel, their defensive rebound, I should say, in Bristol's offensive rebound, and I'm sure there must have been sort of 10, 12 points off offensive board, so that is something that's kind of, you know, really helping Bristol maintain that lead as well, especially when they were struggling to score in that first quarter. Being able to get those second chance or opportunities hasn't done Sheffield any favours at all.
Well, it's Dirk Williams and Chris Taylor who lead all scorers with 10 points apiece at the half, and he's really come alive for the Flyers from the bench.
Yeah, Chris Taylor showing that energy as well. But yeah, really feeling it, and I think having that alley-oop as well is nice to see that for the Flyers fans as well. We haven't really seen an awful lot of Chris Taylor and what he can do, but yeah, he's having a game tonight.
A bit of a stat here from the BBL voice, Dan Routledge: in less than 8 minutes, He's already tied his career high. And again, an incredible game for Chris Taylor as we've reached the end of the first half here in Bristol. We'll be back with you in around 13 minutes' time. Welcome back to the SGS College Arena for the second half of action here between Bristol Flyers and Sheffield Sharks. And it's the hometown Flyers who have an 8-point lead heading into this second half. And Gareth, we've got the stats in front of us here. When you look at those, what numbers pop out to you?
Yeah, certainly the rebounding stats, probably the one that probably has affected Sheffield the most. You know, Bristol winning that battle 27-17, and a lot of those have come on the offensive end as well. So, you know, that's really hurt Sheffield. So they'll want to kind of address that issue, and also just points off the bench as well. You know, Bristol getting more production from their bench as well, 18-2. So, yeah, it's quite interesting. But we can see straight away, it looks like Sheffield are going straight into a zone by the looks of it.
We have seen teams come up with a zone here at the Wise Campus against the Flyers, and it has in the past come off and paid well for those visiting teams. So we'll see how Flyers cope with his own defense in this second half.
Yeah, I think they've switched. It was a ploy. They are back into a man-to-man.
Thousand fires up three off the mark, and a rebound gathered in by Alexander. Here's Collins guarded by Champion, out wide to Marsden. Alexander's going back door. Now here is Alexander, now being guarded by Fausen. Marsden has got a mismatch here on Thomas if he can go to work. Shot clock down to 3 seconds. Kicks it out to Tuck. He likes that spot. And ball goes in and out. Almost stolen away there by Collins. And he's going to stay here with Bristol.
Thomas doing a good job on the defensive end there. You know, he kind of had the mismatch, but body Tuck up quite nicely there. And made him think twice about going to the basket.
His Champion now top to a Dozy. Dozy feeds Gray, mid-range two. And again, the ball goes in and out. Another rebound for Collins. And it's a little bit too much on that pass there from Collins. And
he's not happy. Collins thought the opportunity was there. Marsden didn't quite read it. Bit of a slow start from both teams.
Almost a carbon copy of this the first quarter, which finished 11 points apiece. Here is Champion for three. He gets it to go off the glass, and I think we heard him call bank.
I'm sure I heard something. Yeah, he'll take it though, and so will Coach Kapoulos, that's for sure.
Now it's an 11-point lead for Bristol, which is their largest of the game. Collins skips it to Tuck. Tuck against the Dozy. Opts to shoot the mid-range jump shot, and it's off the mark. Rebound falls to Sheffield Sharks. Shot clock at 10. It's Collins. Beautiful pass into Tuck, and it's stripped away by Adozie. It's always these opening, you know, a lead like 8 points. It's those first few minutes of the third quarter where this game can really go either way. You know, if one team goes on a run, that lead can stretch out to double digits. Or, you know, if the other team goes on a run, it's a really tight ball game going into the fourth quarter.
Yeah, exactly. If you've come a little bit sleepy out of the locker room there, the game can get away with you pretty quickly if one team's kind of firing straight away. I mean, both teams had a better second quarter, and you can potentially lose a game this early if you're not kind of paying attention and switched on.
Ball screen comes from Daniel Adozie, and Champion opts for the mid-range two off the mark. Gathered in by Williams. Here's Collins. Williams thought about the three. Here's Marsden up against Gray. Now Williams at the three-point line. Step back for three. Nothing but net.
Tough shot.
Dirk Williams.
Tough shot. We saw him try a few of those in the first half. Wasn't quite dropping for him, but Tevin Falzone doing a pretty good job on defense there as well. Falzone replying himself.
No good there, and here's Collins the other way for Sheffield Sharks. Beautiful pass there, and again, Sheffield just unable to finish there inside.
Yeah, that was a carbon copy of what we saw in the first half, actually, that sort of 1-2 combination between the bigs. But again, just not dropping for the Sharks.
Alexander for three off the mark. Bobbles around, but ends up falling to Alexander. Makes no mistakes off the glass.
Yeah, Sheffield doing the damage on the offensive boards. We talked about Bristol's offensive rebounding, but Sheffield getting a few of their own now, and it's helping them get back this deficit.
Leads down to six here for the Flyers. Gray turnaround shot, and Williams got a piece on that one, I think. And now here comes Williams the other way in transition for Sheffield. There's Collins. Now Williams. Knocked loose there by Thomas. Now Williams for three again. Back of the rim. Offensive rebound once again falls to Sheffield.
Yeah, Sheffield causing the damage on the glass once more.
An offensive foul there called on Mike Tuck for the moving screen. And he is going to go back to Flyers. You can see the look on Mike Tuck's face there. He goes back the other way.
Yeah, Tuck just asking for an explanation of what he did wrong.
We saw that last weekend when Daniel Adozie had that offensive foul on the moving screen.
Talk about that, do we?
In the last minute against Leicester Riders.
Yeah, what a costly technical foul that was as well.
And Thomas able to draw the contact. And
is that another one for Tuck?
Could be, yeah, there's another foul there on Mike Tuck. He picks up his second personal foul in 30 seconds there.
Looks like he's going to take a bit of a break. Don't want to get him any more foul trouble.
Take seat as Martin comes back into the game. And we talked about the bench points earlier in this game. Chris Taylor with 10 points to lead all scorers at the half, and new BBL career high for him. And it's really come to play here tonight, Chris Taylor.
Yeah, he'll be chomping to get back on as well. You know, when you're feeling it and you're feeling good about yourself, you just want to get on there and feel like you can do it for your team and get you over the winning line as well. So he'll be itching to get back on again.
Leads now back out to eight here for Bristol. We approach the midway point of this third quarter. Here's Hanson Young. Now Dirk Williams, guarded by Tevin Fowler. Thought about the mid-range jumper. Spin move from Alexander, finds Marsden, who makes no mistakes inside.
Yeah, nice movement by Marsden there, saw the guard penetrate and just gave himself a bit of space and was available for that easy little dump off inside. Very effective at that, Sheffield.
Bowser now finds Gray. Gray puts on the moves here.
He's got himself a bit stuck here.
Bowser, beautiful pass to Thomas, who jams it in for two.
So it's a good ball movement themselves there, Bristol. Finish with a flush.
Chance for them to get the fans back into this game. And it's 45-37. We approach the midway point of this third quarter. And Williams for three. Ball goes in and out. Here's Tevin Fowler for the Flyers, our champion. Top to Adozie. Fowler once again. Now Gray. Adozie's got position inside. Takes the mid-range jumper. Turnaround jump shot. It's a tough shot there from Daniel Adozie. And ball finds Dirk Williams. Here's Hanson Young. Alexander. Ball screen come from Marsden. And champion gets called with the foul. Blocking fouls are called. And here's champion just looking for an explanation on that one.
Yeah, both referees are going to call the same foul there as well, so both saw it. Just reaching in, I think. It's just kind of taken, slowed down a little pace now again.
It's a real chess match between these two teams tonight. Very low scoring game indeed. Alexander. Tough shot, and it's blocked by Fred Thomas. And shot clock violation was called, and Excellent defence there from Thomas.
Something that Bristol are known for. Their players very, very much kind of two-way players on their offense and defensive efforts as well, you know.
Thomas, a former defensive player of the year last season out in Norway. And, of course, Justin Gray, always given that assignment of guarding the opposition's best player back in college. Here is Thomas for three. He's feeling it. Almost made that one. The ball goes in and out, and here comes Collins now for the Sharks. Beautiful pass to find Marsden, and it's intercepted by Vigor. He's great.
Mike Vigor with a steal in front of the Vigor fans. They'll have enjoyed that.
And here is Vigor for three.
And they'll have enjoyed that as well.
And Vigor drains the three.
The fan club is up on their feet.
And it's 11-point ball game once again. Collins, Williams curling on the screen. Still with Collins, and the shot clock now down to six. Marsden going up against Adozie inside, and it's a beautiful move, but again, the story of their night, Sheffield, just been unable to finish around the basket. And now here comes Nichols for the Flyers. Chance for Bristol to get their biggest lead of the game. Vigor again for three.
Vigor's feeling it.
And now Vigor back-to-back threes for the Flyers. And now Bristol Flyers with their largest lead of this game.
It's got to be said, if you let Mike Vigor have those open shots and let him take his time and set his feet, you know, you're in trouble there. I think you need to really get on there. You have to respect his shooting ability, because if he's got time, he's going to knock it down.
It's one of his ones as well, because of his height. He doesn't need to jump on that shot. So again, less room for error.
Yep.
And he's really mastered that three-pointer from the top of the three-point line. And you see that a lot now in basketball with big men.
Oh, yeah.
Able to step outside and shoot that threes, really changed the game.
Threes and dunks. That's what you see nowadays, yeah. But it's nice to see, you know, likes of Mike Tuck and Marsden, like, that mid-range kind of game as well, because that's kind of getting out of the game a little bit, I would say. So it's quite nice to see that. But yeah, you know, got big men shooting, well, everyone shooting threes and everyone trying to get to the basket. So just the way the basketball's developing.
Just under 2 minutes to go in this third quarter, and Bristol Flyers, their biggest lead of the game. They lead 51 points to 37. Welcome back to the SGS College Arena, where Bristol Flyers lead the Sheffield Sharks 51 points to 37. And Del Pesce gets caught there with his hand in the cookie jar. Flyers' third team foul. So Sharks are going to inbound from the side. Of course, the first of two games here for the Flyers this weekend. They travel to Manchester Giants on Sunday for a 5 p.m. tip-off. You can catch that action right here on livebasketball.tv. Dirk Williams driving to the hole and unable to finish, but does get fouled. That's more of what you want to see from Dirk Williams. He's really got that ability to draw those defenders in and really be a slasher for his team.
Yeah, he's so athletic and quick as well for a tall guy. Real lean, real athletic as well. And you know, he can certainly shoot, but yeah, like you said, if it's not quite happening, you need to try and find a way of getting to the basket as well, and at the very least get fouled and go to the free throw line. But yeah, just couldn't finish there with the layup.
That's his 10th point of the night so far for 14th point of the night, beg your pardon, for Dirk Williams, making that 15. Nichols looking for Thomas, but finds Vigor. Hand off with Gray. Ball screen comes from Vigor. goes up. Mid-range two, no good. And now here comes Sheffield Sharks.
You could almost argue the same for Gray as well, really, from Bristol point of view. You know, he's settling for these mid-range jumpers. You like to see him go to the basket a little bit more, I think. You know, he's sells for these difficult kind of mid-range shots, and if it's not quite happening, it's a real struggle.
Here is Williams. Tuck's got position on Delpech, and the shot clock expired there on Mike Tuck. He didn't quite see how long was left, I don't think, and just looking around there, like not knowing.
Yeah, well, you'd hope you get a bit of a shout or a call if the shot clock. I was surprised at the shot clock then as well. It caught everyone out of that, I think.
Final minute of this third quarter. Flyers 51, Sharks 39. Here's Vigor, hands off with Thomas. Now Nichols sees the gap. It's knocked loose there by the Sharks, and it's going to stay here with Bristol. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Vigor takes the three, step
He's
back.
Feeling it. Not this time.
Off the mark, but another offensive rebound for the Flyers. And now Nichols tries one from deep. And the rebound falls to Williams. Dirk Williams drives inside, lays it up, no good. And another rebound for Marcus Delpech. And now end to end stuff here for both teams.
Oh, Williams struggling with the layup again.
Vigor. Nichols, final 8 seconds here at the Wise Campus, and the foul is called there on Collins. They have got fouls to give the Sharks.
They do, yeah, this is third foul on Collins. Coach Lyon's going to solid mad on any fouls in the last 6 seconds of the quarter, so making a change.
Greater inbound from the sideline, final 6 seconds of this third quarter. Is Nichols, 3 seconds to go, top to Vigor, has to shoot it here, Mike Vigor. And almost got it to go, Mike Vigor, but back-to-back threes for MJV has really separated these teams here as the Flyers lead 51 points to 39. It's their biggest lead of the game, and Gareth, I mean, from a Flyers point of view, they've held Sheffield to under 40 points in three quarters. Coach K must be really pleased with his side right now.
Yeah, very much so, but I mean, again, we sort of touched on it in the first half. It's not as if Sheffield haven't sort of had opportunities around the basket. It's just it's just not dropping for them at the minute. So, you know, it's good defensive pressure always. But, yeah, Sheffield really not helping themselves either with their field goal percentage.
Well, there's still plenty of time to go in this one for Sharks to mount a comeback. 10 minutes to go, and it's the hometown Flyers who lead the Sheffield Sharks 51 points to 39. Back to the SGS College Arena, where Flyers lead the Sharks 51 points to 39 as we head into the final 10 minutes of action. And Dirk Williams leads all scorers with 15 points, but the story of the game for Bristol Flyers, they've been able to crash the offensive glass, and from a Sheffield Sharks point of view, they've really struggled to get shots going from around the rim.
Yeah, we were just looking at their field goal percentage there, 31% from field goal, and yeah, you know, Bristol done a good job defensively, but they probably expect a little bit more from them, and just 27% from threes, I think they're shooting in a minute.
Back underway here for this final quarter of action. Here's Hansen Young, shot clock down to 7 seconds. Kicks it out to Tuck, who pulls up from the elbow, knocks it down.
Yeah, there's that mid-range game from Mike Tuck.
lead is down to 10.
Sheffield really need to kind of step up this opening kind of salvo, if you like, and get themselves back in the game. They're more than capable.
Linton spins in the lane, just lifted his back pivot foot there, and travelling violation is called. And it's going to be Sheffield Sharks' ball here. Chance for them to narrow this lead back down to single digits. Here's Mike Tuck. Chris Alexander, ball screen comes from Tuck, now Martin, Hanson Young on the wing, looking down low, finds Williams, finds Hanson Young for three. It's good offence there from Sheffield, and once again just unable to finish from behind the 3-point line.
Yeah, really well executed offence, they've got the shot they were looking for, but again just not dropping for them.
Great defence there from Dirk Williams, able to strip Gray. Now Sheffield, another chance for them to cut this lead to single digits. Alexander, beautiful crossover, finds Tuck inside, no mistakes from the big fella. And now the lead is down to 8.
Sloppy turnover.
Oh. Last touch there by Chris Alexander, and a bit of miscommunication there on the pass. Could have been a, costly turnover there from the Flyers.
The Lions not happy with the call. Fortunately for the hometown fans, he's given it to Bristol. So,
well, Chris Taylor's checked back into the game, who leads all scorers for the Flyers. And now his Nichols guided by Hanson Young inside to Vigor. Skips it to Taylor, open for three. Shot was way off the mark there. I think he spent a little bit too much time on the bench.
Yeah, he'd have thought that was his opportunity there, open, the way he's been playing. Fortunately, just came up a little bit short. Hopefully that won't dent his confidence too much, and he'll be able to start where he left off.
8-point game here at the Wise campus. It's Tuck now wide to Williams. Alexander for three.
Big
and
shot.
Now it's a 5-point game here. There's a Sheffield Sharks to narrow that gap all the way down. It's Vigor flying the other way quickly in transition. Taylor drives inside. Vigor now finds Gray for three. Ball goes front iron. Offensive rebound for Nichols. And it's almost stolen away there, but falls to Vigor. And Mike Vigor saying, yep, let's just slow things down here. And they've called it a Sheffield Sharks ball there, but it looked like it came off of I was sat.
Yeah, well, Sheffield were arguing one for them there a minute or so ago that they thought was their ball, so I guess in a way potentially it's evened itself up a little bit. But Sheffield certainly on a rise now, they're peaking a little bit here. Can they take the initiative back from Bristol?
1-point game here, Alexander's feeling it. Just made 1-3 and almost made a second one back-to-back.
Agonisingly close there for Alexander, and that would have been a big shot if that had gone down.
Mike Vigor, now Taylor, inside to Adozie, shot clock at 8 seconds. Not loose there by Tuck.
Difficult angle to make that post-pass there, and Tuck was able to get a hand to it. Lewis Champion checking back in for Jordan. Six minutes 50 left of the last. Only 5 seconds actually left on the shot clock.
New Champion looking for a pass. Five-second violation called there by the officials, and a bit of miscommunication on the play. And see Coach Capullo's just talking through with his coaching staff.
We've seen about the first half seeing a 5-second call. Now we've seen two, both teams not quite the races.
Here's Tuck. The momentum you feel is well and truly in Sharks' favour right now. Alexander. All the way to the basket, and again Sheffield just can't seem to buy a bucket with a layup.
Yeah, they are not having a good time down here at the Wise Arena.
Had plenty of chances to come right back into this game.
Well, they must have missed maybe 15, 16 points.
Here's Vigor, and a foul's called on Martin. And first team foul of this fourth quarter. 7,000 and Panos Mayandombe set to check into this game.
Chris Taylor not quite getting the opportunity to replicate what he did in the first half or the third quarter.
He's Lewis Champion. Skips it to Mayandombe. Dangerous pass there. And Mayandombe able to save it off the defender's legs. Good hustle there from Mayandombe.
He's able to get it. Just need to control it now. Not any any costly mistakes, because it's going to be these sort of errors that are going to cost either team the game as well. So maximum concentration and yeah, doing the simple things. I mean, we've seen Sheffield again miss a handful of layups in this quarter as well, and that can be really costly.
Well, it could indeed be costly. They're still very much in this game. It's 51-46 is the score, and there's 6 minutes to go. Make sure you don't go anywhere, because the final few minutes of this fourth quarter coming right up. Back to the SGS College Arena, where the Bristol Flyers lead the visiting Sheffield Sharks 51 points to 46 in this second place versus seventh place matchup. And of course, you look up and down the league table and you look at the wins and losses, and just a couple of wins separating all those teams in the middle of the pack. It's really a competitive league this season.
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's been said quite a few times, but on their day, you know, teams can take out other teams.
Daniel Dozier able to draw the offensive rebound and able to draw the foul as well. It's going to send him to the free throw line. Yeah. Daniel Dozier's 12th rebound of the game. And 7th in the league in rebounds, Daniel Dozier. But, you know, we've all seen what he can do consistently for the Flyers. He led the league in rebounds in his debut season. And the last couple of games, he's finished with double-doubles as well. Dan knocks down the second, and that pushes the Flyers' lead a little bit further out. Here's Alexander. Now Williams. Williams up against Thomas. Now Alexander drives inside, finds Tuck. He's not loose there, but able to fall to the hands of 7,000. And now here's Lewis Champion. Here's Mayandombe, top to 1,000. 1,000 finds Thomas. Ball screen comes from Daniel Adozie. Shot clock at 8 seconds. Thomas for mid-range two, and nothing but net on that one. Flyers push the lead back out to 8.
Yeah, it'd be nice from a Bristol Flyers point of view if Thomas goes off like he did in the third quarter against Leicester. That would be very reassuring for the home fans. But Sheffield certainly well in this game, and Tuck
lays it up and in. Beautiful move, and the screen left Fred Thomas on the floor. I think he took one in the mouth there. The lead is down to 6. Here's Fred Thomas for 3. An offensive rebound again to Panos Mayandombe, and he's looking for Champion inside, but I don't think he's expecting that one.
Yeah, it was kind of like a good idea by Panos. He saw the opportunity, but just didn't quite execute, and yeah, Lewis certainly wasn't expecting the pass.
4.5 minutes left in this one at the SGS College Arena. Is Williams drives baseline up against Thomas. Now Tuck. Williams once again. Shot clock down to the final 5 seconds. Step back from Dirk Williams. back iron, no good. Rebound scored by Champion.
That's going to be a real crucial matchup, that Williams and Thomas, I think.
Dozy. Now Thomas once again. Thomas feeds it into Fowler. A beautiful bit of two-man game there.
Yep.
And Fowler draws the foul.
Yeah, it could come down to Thomas and Williams. They're both guarding each other as well, so that's going to be in the last 4 minutes of the game. That could be a really interesting matchup.
Justin Gray is also getting set to check back into the game, and I think he's going to come in for Fowler if he knocks down this free throw. The second free throw.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I was waiting for him to come on then. We'll wait for this one.
Oh, I think you saw Justin coming to the bench. He said, no, I want to play a bit more.
Yeah, he wasn't quite ready to go out just yet.
He's Chris Alexander now, guarded by Mayan Dombe. Dirk Williams. Ball screen come from Marsden. Williams drives inside.
Yeah,
foul. I think it's called on Daniel Adozi. Now it's the first team foul on the Flyers in this fourth quarter. And now Fowler will check out of the game for Gray. Balls into Alexander, who drives left. Floats one up, floats it in.
Tough move there by Alexander. He's certainly picked up the energy in this fourth quarter for his team as well.
And the lead is down to 5. 3.5 minutes to go in this one. Still very much anyone's game here. Gray drives inside, kicks it out to Champion for 3. And he gets fouled on the three-point attempt. And Alexander, you can see his reaction to the call. But he's going to send Lewis Champion to the line for 3 shots. Last thing you want from a team of Lions' point of view.
Yeah, it was a difficult call for the player there. There was a referee kind of stood right next to it, and it was a referee slightly further away that made the call. But you know, if you've seen it, got to call it. But yeah, frustrating from Sheffield point of view there.
Champion goes 0 for 2 from the line so far. He's a 76% shooter on the season. Rare pair of misses there from Lewis Champion. The lead remains at 5. Now Lewis Champion unable to convert on all 3 free throws there, and they could be kicking themselves at the end of this one for those 3. Of course, that was the difference in that Leicester game last weekend. Is Tuck now inside to Marsden, up against Gray. Beautiful move, and Marsden makes no mistakes. And now the lead is down to 3.
Yeah, Sheffield certainly picking up that field goal percentage now. Last few trips down the floor, they've come back with something. So, yeah. 3 minutes left to go. Anyone's game.
Need to get the crowd into this game, the Flyers. And Champion now fires up for 3, and he's off the mark once again. And now Sheffield have the chance to tie if they can knock down a 3. Marsden, out wide to Alexander. Alexander pulls up for 3, knocks it down, and we're all tied up.
Big shot by Alexander. Yeah, he's certainly come to play in this fourth quarter.
And they need the fans to get into this game now, the Flyers. They led by as many as 11 points, and Sheffield rallied back in this fourth quarter. And now we are tied up, and that's their 15th foul, the Sheffield Sharks. It's going to send Fred Thomas to the free throw line, and sometimes if you're not feeling it from the field, the best thing to do is to get to that foul line. And
yeah, that could be an important situation with Sheffield in team fouls there. So of course, any foul now, they'll find themselves on the free throw line for 2.
Mike Vicker comes into the game. Mayan Dombe takes a seat, and Vicker checks in for what will likely be these last 2 minutes. Thomas knocks down the first one, puts Bristol back on top by 1. Chance to rebuild that 2-point lead. And Thomas gets the friendly roll again, and
You take them though in this situation. Doesn't matter how they doesn't matter how they go in, as long as it goes in.
We've reached the final 2 minutes here of the fourth quarter. It's a two-point game here at the Wise campus. Marsden going to work down low, finds Williams for three, knocks it down, Dirk Williams, and now Sheffield Sharks are on top by one.
Yeah, Dirk Williams, Alexander, both stepping up in this fourth quarter. They are the talisman for the Sheffield team, leading scorers.
Is bigger now, top to champion. Ball screen comes from Daniel Adozi. Final 100 seconds left in this one. And Gray for three. Front iron, no good. Rebound gathered in by Collins. And now Sharks chance to extend their lead. Here's Mike Tuck. Guarded by Adozi. Now inside to Marsden, up against Vigor. Marsden going to work down low, skips it to Williams again for three. And back iron, no good. Offensive board falls to the Sharks. And now we approach the final minute of this ball game. Sharks on top by one. Alexander turns the corner. The foul's on Thomas. And they've got fouls to give here, the Flyers. Their second team foul of this fourth quarter.
Sets to 14 seconds. Shot clock.
Ball's into Alexander. Ball screen comes from Marsden. Now skips it to Collins. Collins up against Champion. Goes to work inside. Beautiful pass to find Marsden, who now finds Williams deep three. Back-to-back threes there for Dirk Williams, who's feeling it now at the SGS College Arena. And Sheffield Sharks, they've rallied back into this game, and just when they've needed it, Dirk Williams has come out firing all from all cylinders.
Yeah, Williams and Alexander there. Bit of theatrics on the way off the court as well. They know they're both feeling it right now, and that is very ominous for a Bristol Flyers there as well. And they've not got much in the last few trips down the offensive end for Bristol and Sheffield with some big, big buckets.
20 points now for Chris, 21 points, I beg your pardon, for Dirk Williams, who leads all scorers in this one. And final 46 seconds, if you're Coach Kapoulos, you're still chance to tie or, get right back into this game in these next few possessions. What is it that you're saying to your team here?
Just got to keep control, make sure they get good opportunities, good looks, and defensively, you know the two guys at the Sheffield are going to want to try and get the ball to. So you have to do a good job. I mean, they had a hand in the face. They're just big shots from big players for Sheffield as well. But, you need someone to step up offensively for Flyers. As I said, it's been a bit tricky the last couple of times down the floor as well. So, you have to find some easy looks or someone to step up, make a big shot. But there's plenty of time. 46 seconds left. 4 seconds in the game. 4 points in the game. Lots of time.
And if you're Coach K, which player are you looking to in that five out there on the court to get those get those points for you out there?
Well, Fred Thomas, we know, but Mike Vigor's been, he's had a few good looks as well. So, but Sheffield will obviously know this, and they'll be overplaying Fred Thomas quite a bit, I would have thought, as he's got the ball now.
Big possession here for the Flyers, and Thomas kicks it out to Vigor, skips it to Champion, who needed that shot. Dirk Williams comes out of nowhere, swatted away.
Doing it all, Williams on offense and on defense as well. That'll unsettle Bristol as well. It was a good ball movement, good shot in the corner, but Williams with a massive block. Timeout called, Bristol.
Coach K is going to talk things through here for the Flyers. 38.1 seconds left in this one. And it's Flyers who led all the way through this second half, now find themselves trailing here in these final few minutes. Make sure you don't go away anywhere, because this game could go either way here. The final 38 seconds is Bristol Flyers 57, Sheffield Sharks 61. Thank you. Welcome back to the SGS College Arena, where it's crunch time here for the Flyers. Chance for them to chip back into this lead. The trail by four here. Champion's going to inbound. Champion finds Bigger. Almost lost it there. And now here's Fred Thomas. Got to shoot it here. And Fred Thomas pulls up. Back of the iron, no good. Offensive rebound for Justin Gray, who puts it in for two. Final 29 seconds left in this one. It's a two-point game.
Sheffield look to slow it down a little bit now, try and take as much time off the clock as possible.
There's 3 seconds here between shot and game clock. Alexander looking to hold it here for the Sharks. Knocked loose there by Champion. Collins. And travelling violation there on Collins. And Flyers now with 7.4 seconds left in the clock have a chance to tie or win the game with a three. What is it you go for, Gav?
You got to go for the best opportunity within 7 seconds. If that's a three, if it's going to the basket, you just got to take it. Take whatever's given to you, you know?
7.4 seconds to go. Flyers down by two. It's Thomas. 5 seconds to go. Gray on the wing for the win. Oh! Justin Gray wins the game for Bristol Flyers.
0.2 of a second left. It's not quite done.
What a play from Justin Gray.
Struggled all game with that shot. Comes up big.
Timeout's called here on the floor. Dirk Williams came out with those back-to-back threes. Giving that four-point lead, their biggest lead of this second half. And then Justin Gray comes up, ice in his veins, knocks down that three-point jump shot. And you look at the officials are just talking to the table, I think, there. I'm not quite sure what the...
Andreas saying it's over, and I don't know. We're not sure who called the timeout or if there's enough time to do anything.
The timeout is called on the floor, and 0.2 of a second. I mean, is that enough to even get a shot up? Or you got to tip it in, I guess?
Yeah, I guess you just got to lob it up and... Yeah, so this, there could be another dramatic twist in the tail here.
Well, they are going to inbound the ball, Sheffield, from the front court. So they're going to have to just lob it up and hope for a quick tip in.
And they've certainly got the athletes to do it.
And both teams back out here on the floor. 0.2 seconds left in this one. Flyers on top by one. It's Collins to inbound for the Sharks. See what Atiba Lyons has drawn up here.
It's going to be a lob.
Looking to lob it into Tuck, and it's blocked by Vigor. And that's going to do it here for the Flyers. It's Justin Gray who's taken all the plaudits here for the Wise Campus. He's the hero that's led Flyers back to winning ways here at the SGS College Arena. What a fantastic ending that was to this game.
Yeah, incredible shot right at the end there. Saving is like all the excitement of the game was in that final 2 seconds of the game, really. The fans are on their feet. Yeah, it was a bit of an attritional game, shall we say, up until that point as well. But, you know, full credit to Sheffield. They had a really strong fourth quarter and really unlucky to lose it right at the end there as well. But big shot from Gray to secure this, to break this losing streak for the Bristol Flyers.
Well, it was a all-around team effort for Flyers in the win. Three players finished the game on 10 points. Gray, Thomas, and, of course, Chris Taylor off the bench with those 10 first-half points. As Flyers return to winning ways, and for Sheffield Sharks, they were led by Dirk Williams, his 21. He came out all guns blazing in that fourth quarter, but just fell short there for the away team.
Yeah, it was a really good effort, you know, said from the two main guys at Sheffield there as well. They stepped up big time in that fourth quarter. Probably didn't deserve to be on the losing team the way they performed there as well, but Bristol sort of dug in, held on, gave themselves an opportunity to win, And Justin Gray, yeah, struggled from the floor all night, I thought, but came up massive with that shot to win the game.
Well, that's going to do it here from the SGS College Arena. The final score, 62 points to 61. There's still plenty of action to come this weekend on livebasketball.tv. Of course, Flyers now will go into Sunday's game against Manchester Giants full of confidence. But tomorrow, Surrey Scorchers, they're at home to Cheshire Phoenix. Leicester Riders are hosting the Plymouth Raiders. And then we mentioned the Flyers are back in action against Manchester on the road. And the London City Royals are hosting the Worcester Wolves on livebasketball.tv. You can catch all those games right here. But for tonight's game, Bristol Flyers 62, Sheffield Sharks 61. For Gareth Till, I'm Joel Osborne saying so long, and we'll see you next time.